What's up, YouTube? Cole Lawson here, and I am back with another video. So it's a really gloomy day in LA, and it's Memorial Day weekend, but I kind of just don't even feel like doing anything today. I kind of just want to cook some really good comfort food and just kind of chill out and watch Netflix all day today. I think rest is very important. It should be an important part of your spiritual journey. It should be an important part for you to just kind of like reset. And you shouldn't feel pressured to have to like go out and party or turn up all the time. So yeah, last night I actually went to a pottery class with my friends and it was super dope, super fun, kind of challenging, but it was super fun to like step out of my comfort zone and do something that we don't normally do. So, that being said, I thought that I would record a couple videos for you guys today, including like a vlog of me recording videos. So I'm probably gonna like cook some food. I'm thinking like some vegan like dumpling soup situation. So right now, well, I'm burning my Palo Santo because you know I can't leave the house without getting some energy going. Okay, I think I'm gonna do dumplings. And maybe like some avocado egg rolls. I might just go ahead and fuck it up in the kitchen one time, okay? So I'm gonna do that. I'll probably record some videos, probably watch some Netflix. So I'm just gonna kind of bring you guys around with me for a little bit. I'm gonna go to the grocery store and get some of the things that we need for the dumplings. So I will see you guys in a bit. Okay, y'all, I'm in the car. So I think I'm gonna go to Whole Foods because I'm gonna grab some oyster mushrooms. I think I wanna do oyster mushrooms inside the dumplings as like my meat sub filler. One thing you guys will know about me as we progress through these videos and like I share more of like my vegan recipes with you guys and I share more of just like how I go about healing myself so you can take whatever is for you, you know, is that I have started to like really fully move all the way into this vegan life, okay? By simply saying like I used to think like being vegan was so expensive, it was so hard, all these things, and honestly it was just me not taking out the time to learn recipes, to learn what I like to eat and how I wanted it to be prepared, and not really wanting to grocery shop or figure out the substitutes that would be best for me. Once I figured all that out, I've been fucking the game up in this kitchen, okay honey? Listen, fucking it up and eating good, okay? But being vegan is not expensive at all and it's not hard, but you need to stop going to the grocery store and buying all the processed vegan stuff, like the processed vegan meats and things like that, because those things aren't really good for you. Because you got to think, companies' concerns is not really your health. Their concern is making money, so they need to put what they need to put in it to make it taste good so they can sell it to you, right? Because you're not going to buy it if it don't taste good. But the best bet is to eat whole foods and whole vegetables and season them and make it your own. Get, you know, get a little special with it in the kitchen. Put some special seasoning and make a special sauce. Do something. But the thing is, you got to eat whole foods. You got to eat whole vegetables and whole fruits. And, you know, all the processed food, no matter where it's coming from, even if it doesn't have meat in it, really isn't good for your body taking in all that processed shit. So I do encourage you guys to, you know, try and make more meals that are like whole food meals. And I know the switch isn't easy and I'm not sitting here saying it is because it's been a long time coming, okay y'all? This is me 5 years strong and I have, you know, cheated throughout the years and all types, and not even calling it cheated because I believe in conscious eating, conscious healthy living. So even if you don't want to be vegan or vegetarian, just being conscious of what it is that you're putting in your body and how it makes your body feel and how your body is functioning because of all these things is what's important. Because I don't like to put myself in a box because then other people have expectations of you, and fuck y'all expectations. I love y'all, but fuck y'all expectations, okay? Because I'm gonna do whatever feels best for me at whatever time it feels best for me, and that's the same attitude that y'all should have about everything in your life. Do what's best for you, boo. You're the one living this experience, nobody else. So yeah, let's get to this grocery store because y'all know a girl could talk, okay? Bye. You guys, our bodies are so intelligent. Like, imagine when you break your bone, what do? They fucking just splint that shit up and put it back together and let it heal itself. When you get like cuts or scrapes or whatever, the skin might be broken for a bit, but then what does it do? It heals itself. So we know that the body is capable of healing itself, which means you're capable of healing yourself. You see where I'm going with this? But you have to put your body in the right environments. You have to provide it with the right nutrients in order to be able to heal itself. Okay, dis-ease is comfort in your body. Dis-ease, your body is dis-ease. Okay, it's out of alignment. To get back in alignment, all you have to do is provide it with the right nutrients, the right resources, and your body can heal itself. That's what we mean by healthy eating or healthy living or healthy lifestyles. If you break up the word healthy, it literally says heal thy. You know what I'm saying? So heal thyself. Heal thyself through your eating habits, through your, you know, your water intake, through your maintenance, through the energies you keep around you, the motherfucking friends you got in your circle, okay, the music you're listening to, all the things. But self-healing is definitely top priority, okay?
In 1 mile, turn left onto Topham Street.
Okay, Siri. Oh, wait for it, girl.
Uber on the way, my phone is charging.
But I figured since I'm gonna cook today, you know, your girl gonna get a little bit of wine, okay? I prefer red wines, y'all. Oh, my favorite, absolutely, because it's here right now, is the Ménage à Trois Silk Red Blend. That is my favorite wine of all time. So I'm gonna grab that. I already got my groceries, see you guys. Already got my groceries. I obviously forgot to freaking vlog. But yeah. Okay, y'all. So I just got home from grocery shopping. So I have my groceries and I got my wine. So I'm about to go in the house and kind of like get this started, because I know it's going to take a little bit. And I'd be dragging ass, not going to lie. But I was just on Instagram and I was like touching on a couple topics. So I kind of wanted to include that in this video because I feel like maybe somebody else needs to hear it. Because we talk about trust issues all the time, especially when it comes to being in romantic relationships. And kind of what I was talking about on my Instagram, if you're not following me, it's at I am Colawson, EYEAMCOLELAWSON. I'll insert the thing, you know. Anyways, but we get in relationships and then we tend to just fall into people. You know, and then we stop living our own lives, we stop hanging out with our friends, or we start, you know, we become one person instead of being two people and expanding outwards. It's like we shrink into each other and then create this little bubble to live around instead of expanding our reach, because two lights are always going to shine brighter than one, okay? But I was talking about trust issues and how, you know, from personal experience, I realized that in order for me to be in another relationship where I wasn't afraid, because I had been cheated on so many times and, you know, people had done me wrong so many times, in order for me to be in a relationship with anyone, I had to fix my trust issues within myself, because I would get into separate relationships or situationships and I would say, you know, things like, oh, I have trust issues. And I would say things like, oh, I trust you, but I don't trust the other people. Or, you know, I just wouldn't trust them because of things that they did. Fuck shit that they done did, okay? But at the end of the day, you can't control anyone else. Everyone is living their own experience in life. So in knowing that and really understanding that, now that I haven't been in a relationship for about 3 years, it's me really realizing that my trust issue was never with the other people. My trust issue, deep down, rooted underneath, was with myself, because I had allowed people to do me wrong so many times, and I did not walk away from them. I did not uphold my boundary with myself, so that kind of weighed on my self-worth, and it weighed on, you know, how I felt about myself and my securities or insecurities for that matter. So trust issues don't come from other people, because people are people. They change their mind. They do shit randomly all the time. Some people do shit they didn't even know that they was going to do, you know. The real trust issue comes, and that real fear comes from not trusting yourself to walk away from a situation you should walk away from. Because sometimes we fall in love with people, and, you know, we get upset because they hurt our feelings, but we stay anyways, even though they've crossed the line or they've crossed our boundary, because we don't trust ourselves enough to just walk away, because we're not used to upholding and maintaining boundaries and keeping promises to ourselves. So what I had to realize is, in order to change my relationship with people, in order to be in a relationship where I wasn't afraid or always looking over my back if someone was going to cheat on me, was to repair my trust issues with my motherfucking self. And how you do that, because y'all know I'm going to coach you real quick. Okay, how you repair your trust issues with yourself, the number one way is make a small promise to yourself every day and keep it. Start by that. Make a small promise to yourself every day and keep it. Whether it's, you know, you're going to meditate for 5 minutes, you're going to journal every morning when you get up, you're going to drink a glass of water every morning when you get up. It could be something super small. Make a super small promise to yourself every single day and keep it. That's how you start the journey of repairing your trust issues with yourself, is showing up for yourself and doing the things that you said you're going to do. Another good way to repair your trust issues with yourself is to become a very decisive person. You know, we start to gain trust issues and then we get indecisive in our life because we don't feel like we know how to make the right choices because things didn't always play out the way that we wanted them to play out. So taking every opportunity to choose is also another healthy way and a great way to start repairing your trust issues. So one, make a small promise to yourself every day. Two, always take an opportunity to choose and intentionally choose what it is you want in your life, whether it be food, makeup, hair colors, shoe colors, nail color, all the shit, okay? Intentionally choose what you want in your life, so that way when you're presented with situations where you have to make hard choices, you make the choices that are aligned with you, even when they do hurt. You guys, because loving someone unconditionally and caring about someone doesn't mean you can't walk away from them. Sometimes there's so much more love in you leaving than there ever would have been in you staying. And that means love for you and love for another person, because sometimes you're snatching away an opportunity for their growth and your growth when you stay in a situation that's not conducive to growth, okay? When you're staying in an environment that's not nurturing you anymore, that's not nurturing you, that's not nurturing the other person. So sometimes there's a lot more love in walking away from a situation and staying. So fixing your trust issues is not about trying to control another person, because you cannot control another person no matter how much you want. No matter if you're with the person 24/7, if somebody wants to do something, where there's a will, there's a motherfucking way, okay? They will find a way to do it. So you need to worry more about trusting yourself to walk away from things that are no longer serving you when it is time, okay? That is where you need to rebuild your trust at. That's where you need to put your focus on, because people will be people. And people will fuck you over. And people do things, you know, that may not have been intentionally to fuck you over, but people put themselves first. People think about themselves. So therefore, you need to start thinking about yourself and start rebuilding that trust within yourself by making promises and keeping them. And the last healthy way, you know, is once you get more in depth to it, is create some healthy, solid boundaries in your life. You need to know, what is your trigger? What is your no-go? What is not happening, okay? But boundaries are actions, okay? A boundary has to be attached to an action, and it should not matter who crosses the boundary, because the boundary is for you, it's not for the other person. It doesn't mean you don't care about them or love them, it means you care about you and you love you, and you need to uphold the same standard of boundary for every single person in your life, because that is your boundary, okay? Not dependent on anybody else, okay? It doesn't have to be a conditional boundary, if, you know. But anyways, I'll make a whole nother video on boundaries and actually how to set them, how to maintain them, how to keep them, and how to enforce your boundaries without feeling bad and feeling guilty and all those things, okay? But yeah, so I just wanted to touch on that aspect of relationships for a bit, because it's something that I reflect on, I go back to, and I still reflect on, you know, as I'm cultivating myself to become the person that I want to be in my next relationship, okay? And I'm becoming the person that I want to attract in my next relationship by adopting all the same attitudes, you know. I know now that I need a relationship that allows me freedom. I need a relationship that allows me individuality. And I know that I fall in love, and I fall in love hard, and I fall in love deep. So I also need a partner that is going to hold me accountable just as much as I hold them accountable, you know. Like somebody that's not going to just take advantage of the fact that I will just fall head over heels for them. And that's something that I noticed, because sometimes we do need a little help. And it's okay to say that. It's okay to admit that you need a little help, that you, you know, you can't just uphold all the things by yourself. We're still human. I'm still human. You're still human. And we're all just trying to figure this shit out. But I hope that helps someone else. Maybe that feels like they have trust issues in their relationship, even though their partner hasn't done anything. You know, you have these vibrations that you're carrying from past relationships or past situations with other people. And sometimes, you know, you've never been hurt, but you know that people can hurt people, you know. So I always tell anyone that I work with, like, trust issues come from yourself, because the only person you need to trust in this life is you. You don't have to trust anybody else. You need to trust that you are going to do what you need to do for yourself when the time comes, okay? But trusting other people, it's easy. It's easy to give a motherfucking trust, but once they lose it, it's hard to get it back. It's one of the hardest things ever to get back, if you ever get it back, and it's probably never going to be 100 again after that. But you can always learn to retrust yourself, because, you know, that's the only thing you have control over. You have control over you and your actions and your reactions and your responses. So if you're having trust issues and you need a little bit more guidance, feel free, hop in the comments. Let me know if you're having trust issues, if you resonate with that or not, or if it's just me, whatever. That's cool if it's just me. But let me know if you were having trust issues and I kind of opened your eyes a bit, and now you see that the trust is within yourself, because you ain't been walking away from Tyrone ass when you should have been walking away from that nigga, okay? Or, you know, whatever. Let me know. I'm going to go in the house and make this food, because I didn't know that that little spill was going to be 9 minutes. Might have to chop, screw it up. Okay. Talk to you in a bit. Bye. Come on, turn this up. Turn it up. Turn it up, Siri. I broke my goddamn wine opener. I'm back. I know we had a little bit of technical difficulties, but your girl broke her damn wine opener in the thing. So, you know, I went to YouTube University and got a degree in how to open a wine bottle without an opener, okay? And here we are, and I'm gonna pull it up while I get ready to make this food. I decided that I'm making some dumpling soup and some avocado rolls all from scratch. So I'm gonna do the thing and pour it up. So if you're watching this and you're having a drink with me, cheers! Let's get cooking. I'm about to put these in some water because it's Sunday and I feel good. I just picked these from my garden. Soup. I made it. The filling has onions and ginger and What else? Oh, oyster mushrooms with some sesame oil. And some other stuff that I'll mix up in there. If y'all want the recipe for that, drop it down below. Let me know and I will go ahead and make a whole video just with the recipe for you, boo, for you. And then I made some avocado rolls. Who do I think I am? I don't even know. But let me show y'all this before I go ahead and tear it down. I know my presentation really isn't that great and I got like blue plates because I'm childish, but whatever. This, oh my goodness, I can't even. Oh. I can't wait. I'm a little tipsy. Look, I just zoomed the camera all the way and I have lipstick on my chin. Okay, obviously I should go away and try this again. See you in a bit. So what up, y'all? I just sat down so I could eat my food and finish drinking my wine. I might be a little tipsy now. I don't really know. We're gonna find out. I know I'm a little greasy, but look, I'm hungry. Your girl not gonna get up and go to the bathroom and pat this off. So we'll live, okay? So real spit, I'm kind of a little bit of an overworker, overachiever. And not just that, but I read a lot. I read a lot. I enjoy my silence. I enjoy listening to my thoughts, observing my thoughts, deciphering what it is my body's feeling. So I don't watch a lot of TV. My friends always ask me, like, I don't watch any shows. I'm not caught up with shows. Even when I start shows with people, I be telling them, like, go ahead, you can finish it because I'm probably not going to finish it. But I sat down so I could watch some TV and I don't really know what I'm going to watch on this Netflix thing because I ain't really been on here in a minute. But we're going to figure it out. Because this food is fire. And I'm having a little relaxing ass day, okay? So, we're going to see. Hopefully, I can find something good to watch. I'll let y'all know what I watch. Ooh, I wish. Is Pose back on? Or did they just put this on Netflix? Oh, okay. This is only season one. Pose was such a good show, y'all. Such a good ass show. I can't wait for season two. I did watch that. I watched that with my old roommate when we lived together. But, yeah. And I just watched this other show. I watched this other show on there when I was on vacation. I usually watch TV when I'm vacationing, which is weird. But I watched this show. Fuck, what was it called? Oh, Chambers. That shit was wild. It was really good, though. But yeah, so I'm going to find something to watch, and I'll see y'all later. Okay, y'all. So the movie I chose to... Look, can't see me? Okay, let me turn this way. The movie I chose to watch was Obsessed, obviously, as you can see right here. And let me tell y'all, this white girl is fucking cray, for one. And for two, when Beyonce went to the hospital and she met up with her husband and her husband was, like, telling her to shit, I would have to believe my husband. She was acting cray. I would have to believe him because, first of all, I would have been like, nigga, you losing your motherfucking mind if this is what happened. So if you're telling me to stay, I must have to believe you. It must have to be some weird shit that went on because you would have had me fucked up because I'm not the one, the two, or the three. Okay? So I'm just looking at this like Beyonce pissed off and I would have had to think that the girl had to be lying because niggas can't be that wild. They can't be that crazy. Okay? Not to lie to you in your face like that. But you know what? Niggas will lie to you in your face, so I don't even know. But yeah, I'm watching Obsessed, y'all. That's what I settled on. Be back later. I'm trying to record a video for y'all right now. Okay. Trying to record a video. I was just like, yeah, I've been savoring my wine because I've been trying real hard not to be drunk because I knew I wanted to record some videos. But look, I'm slowly on my way.
outside, just wash my face because I'm getting ready to like probably watch more Netflix and then lay down because I just edited a couple videos. But so I just washed my face, so I kind of wanted to show you guys what I put on my face afterwards. So twice a week, I usually, if I'm not using like aloe vera gel or doing like a turmeric mask, if you guys want me to like link, do a video on my aloe vera gel mask or my turmeric mask, drop that shit down in the comments. But just on a regular day to keep my skin hydrated, I love this Laneige, I think that's how you say it, Laneige hydrating water face mask. I got this maybe like a year ago, and it's, no, maybe not a year, maybe like 6 months, and it's lasted me a really long time. Honey, I be waking up and my skin be on glow, on hydrate, on swim, on wave, on dip, on water, on all the shits, okay? My shit be like ocean wet. Okay, maybe not ocean wet, it don't be that wet. But my shit be glowy, it be nice, okay? So I use this, you keep it on overnight, and then you wake up in the morning and you rinse it off. I also have their lip mask. It's downstairs in my purse. I'm about to go grab it and I'll show y'all. I've been using that for about 6-7 months. I got them at the same time, but I've been using that for 6-7 months. And honey, it's a sleep lip mask, but I use that shit all day, every day, like it's my chapstick. Because if anybody knows anything about me, I do not like my lips being chapped. And that shit is so fire. It leaves your lips plump. It smells good. I love the texture of it, the whole nine. So I'm gonna show you guys that in a minute, and then I'm probably gonna watch some more Netflix. So yeah, let me show y'all this lip mask. Yeah, it's like kind of blurry. Okay, so that's the face mask. I'm gonna set this on the stairs. And this is the Laneige lip mask. Yeah, the Laneige lip. Come on, light. There we go, the Laneige lip mask. Let me open it up because my lips is actually dry because I just got, and yeah, see, look, like as you can see, and this is me having it for like 6-7 months, maybe. I kind of think I, no, 7 months, maybe 8 months I've had this, and I use it every single day, and it's barely a dent in it. Like, this shit's gonna last me for so long. But yeah, it's the truth, y'all. And I be using a generous amount, not gonna lie. Especially at night, I use a generous amount on my lips. But yeah, that's the truth. Other than this, on my lips, I usually use the regular chapstick, the blue one. Just basic, regular-ass blue chapstick. The original, okay? Because when they be trying to remix shit, it don't be coming out right. The originals be with the shit. So yeah, I'm about to put this this water sleeping mask on because it's kind of cold outside. I was going to do an aloe vera mask, but my aloe vera plant is outside and it's a little brisk, okay? Your girl not trying to go in the cold. So I'm just going to do this one and that's going to be that. See you in a bit.
The first time in years, got my feet crossed the border from a land of tears.
Grand rising, you guys. Good morning, good morning. So it is currently, what time it is, shorty? It's 7:39 in the morning, Pacific Standard Time. So I'm about to get up. The first thing I do in the morning is I write down my gratitude. So I'm going to write down my gratitude. I'm going to journal for a bit. And I'm going to meditate. And then I'll come back. Because this is weird for me. I feel like recording this just, like, took me out of like my morning thing. But it's good. I'm expanding. That's why it's uncomfortable. But good morning. I hope your morning started off well. Good morning, puppy boy. Good morning, honey bun. But yeah. So I'm going to hop to it so I can get this vibration, this vibrational level together. Okay, see you soon. Alright guys, it's about 8:20. I just got done meditating, doing my gratitude. I have my water, my vitamins, all my morning things. If you like a morning routine video, you know what to do. Drop down in the comments. I know you don't hear me say that a billion times. However, I'm going to take my dog for a walk and get ready for my day. And start planning out my intentions and what I'm going to do today and do this week. But yeah, so the message I want to leave you guys with today is always follow your heart into situations. I know people say think logically, use your brain, all these things, but I really feel like this shift in time that we're going into is we've been using our brains so much that we forget to use our hearts. We forget that these also are second brains. I like to think that we have three brains in our body, the one in our head, the one in our heart, and the one in our gut. But the one in our heart is super important. There are more neural pathways going to your brain from your heart than from your brain to your heart. Okay, which means it's a powerful muscle. It's a powerful tool. It's a powerful instrument. I mean, if it stops beating, you stop living. Okay, so it's very important that you start using your heart in some situations. Start having some compassion, some empathy. Start feeling around things, because at the end of the day, we're all chasing things, we're chasing ideas, we're chasing people because we want to feel a certain way. So sometimes when you're going through a situation and you need some guidance, see how it feels, okay? See how these responses that you're giving yourself feel. See how some energies play out inside of your body. And then move accordingly to how you feel, because at the end of the day, that's what you're chasing. You're chasing that feeling regardless. All right. So if you like this vlog, like, comment, subscribe to my channel, share with your friends, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, y'all.